head to Peck Ranch today to do some shed hunting. See if we can't find some whitetail sheds, maybe possibly some elk sheds. I got my wife Sarah with me. I've got Isaac with me.
What's up, guys?
And we're meeting Dave Hannigan down here too. So we're gonna go through, see if we can hopefully find something. We'll pick up the video when we get down there. Meeting up with Dave. God bless y'all. See you in a little bit. We made it down here to Peck Ranch and we're in the first field. Isaac's over there checking a little patch of woods. Sarah's right here next to me. We're just kind of waiting on Dave. I thought, well, while we're waiting on him, we might as well check the little bit of area where we're already at. Maybe we might find something waiting on him. The deer are dropping antlers pretty good in the areas that we have been checking so far. I did check a spot outside of Peck Ranch not too long ago and did find one decent small shed. It wasn't a big deer by no means, but we're just gonna kind of get over here to the edge of the field and kind of right here where the woods meet the field here a little bit and see if we can't find something right in here. Be kind of cool. Of course, whenever we do find them, if we do find some, we'll probably go up and talk to the conservation and see if we're allowed to keep them from out of here. I don't know if we are or not. I know where it's not illegal for us to walk around and look, but I don't know if we're allowed to keep them. So we'll probably gather them up. We'll go talk to Preston about it, see if it's something we're allowed to keep or not. So we'll get back to you guys if we find something. God bless y'all, and we'll see you soon. Okay, I'm back. I hadn't moved an inch before I started the video back up. So you're seeing what I'm seeing right now. Maybe you guys will spot something I didn't spot. We can come back later and get it. Man, it's kind of chilly out here today. There was a good thick frost this morning whenever we woke up at 6 o'clock. And right now it is 9:32. We've seen a few conservation agents. No one's really stopped and talked to us to see if we weren't supposed to be in here or nothing. But here's a heavy beat down trail right here, and we're going to follow it. Get over here, check this creek bank. No, we're not done. No, this isn't the only place we're gonna check. We're just kind of waiting on Dave before we really, really start looking. This is just one of the first little areas. This is where we stopped. This is where we told Dave we'd meet up with him at. So we're just kind of combing through here and seeing what we can find. That this is Peck Ranch. This is the wildlife refuge. There's a load of deer. There's elk in here. Lots of big turkeys. Be kind of nice to find a elk shed. That'd be really cool. I don't think we'd be allowed to keep an elk shed if we found one in here. But just be able to find it on camera, that'd be really neat. And we'll turn it in if we have to. I really hope we don't have to, but I can see Sarah. She's way down over there. But I really want to get up on that next ridge over there, but I don't want to get too far away from the vehicle. I want to be here whenever Dave gets here. That is if Dave even gets to come. I don't know if he's going to make it or not, but he said he'd meet us here, so we'll wait for him before we really move on. Of course, this is just as good a place as any to check, you know. So, but you can see that this is, you see right there, you can see the big hillside. There's a lot of deer that bed right there. Let me check these areas like this right here. Just lots and loads of places to look around here. It's fresh deer poop. But, you know, this is a wildlife refuge, but it's for the public. It's for people to be able to come in and do the elk tours and be able to come in and be one with nature and a place where the animals are safe and they got a haven here and there's a load of deer in here. I know I haven't, there's a good scrape right there. I haven't seen as many whitetail in this area since they brought the elk in. But that don't mean that they're not here. And I don't know where Isaac went. Where did he go? Sarah's went way off in there somewhere. Hey, Ike. He says he's going to stay close to me because he's missing a contact today. So he don't have the eyesight that he normally does. I really wish we had some binoculars today. That would definitely make this that much easier today. I just seen Sarah. I thought, I hate it when we get separated like that, but everyone sees something they want to go check out, so they go check it out. I was really wanting to stay close together today, but just because of the elk, and, you know, I don't think they're going to attack us, but you never know. They are wild animals. They're unpredictable animals, so. I may have to stop and put my gloves on. There's some rabbit ice. A little bit of rabbit ice right there. Okay, we're going to get off in here again. Follow this trail that I just found. Of course, I'm not sure if it's an elk or if it's a deer trail, but it's a trail and we're going to follow it. Boo. There's some big old elk poop right there. There's an even better trail. This one led right into a really good trail. So, and I'm right back to the creek. I don't know if there's a way to get across that creek, but I really want to go check the edges of that field out. Alright guys, I'm going to stop the video here for a little bit, and I'll get back with you guys if we find something. Yeah, a little bit, yeah. It goes in and out, but I got it standing right there anyway. You can see too. Alright guys, this is Dave. Oh, you got some jerky? Heck yeah. Sweet, thank you. Isaac's way up in there somewhere. He tore out of here before we all started. We searched a lot of that over there already and didn't see nothing. We found a dead deer, but there wasn't no head of it.
Yeah, I had to swing my mic as far.
Yeah. Well, this is one I'm wanting to search the most out of all of them. And then there's another one up on top of the ridges we'll probably check.
Okay. You go one side and I'll go the other.
That's what we're going to try to do. First one of the day right here. Looks about like last year's. On to the next one.
No sheds yet, but I did find some elk fur. That's pretty neat. It was just stuck inside of this limb right here. It's pretty cool. Found something, at least. That's only been about 5 minutes since I stopped recording last.
Time today is 11:41, and we've only found one shed. This just doesn't seem like, you'd think, you know, coming into Peck Ranch, a wildlife refuge, it'd be pretty simple to go and find some sheds in here, but that's not the case. It's become very difficult, actually. We found one shed, and it was an old shed from last year. Isaac found it. At the very first place where we started. But now I'm down off here in these bottoms, and hopefully we're able to find it. It's beautiful, beautiful down in here. You know, it's not a wasted trip. The trip's definitely worth it. We're getting to walk around in some of my family's old property that I haven't been in years because it belongs to the conservation now. We're just kind of home in the area. Sarah's up there on top of that ridge, somewhere up in there. I'm going down through the bottom here, see if we can't find something. So hopefully we do. Guys, keep your fingers crossed and pray we find something today. Make this trip just that much more worth it. You know, being here is worth it. You know, being here and doing what we're doing, being out here in the outdoors, even after the hunting seasons are over, getting to do what we love to do, just walking through the woods, being in nature. That makes it worth it to me. There's Sarah right there. I just seen her. But I'm gonna jump off here. If we find something, I'll jump back on here. We didn't find any sheds but one. Isaac found it. But at least we got to see some deer. There's a big mama doe and a yearling. Some pretty good looking deer out there, guys. So, well, we're going to keep on driving down through here. And we're going to take her kind of slow and just see what we can find driving through here. Who knows, maybe we'll have a big old buck jump across the road and knock his antlers off in the middle of the road for us. Wouldn't that be some pure luck? Yeah, very wishful. All right, guys, I'm going to jump off here for now, and I'll get back to you guys in a little while. Now, here's why we ain't finding any elk sheds, obviously. I didn't think we would on elk, honestly. I wasn't even thinking that was going to happen. But there's a big bull elk, and there's a cow right there behind it, right there in front of it. He ain't a monster bull elk, but he's a pretty cool-looking bull elk. I'd like to have them antlers once he drops them off. Isaac should be right here somewhere. He said he was walking down the hill down here. That's the hill we were on right there. I don't see him nowhere. Oh well. Alright, guys, I'm gonna jump off here and hopefully we can find Isaac. Yeah, we'll just try calling him.
Into a big old bull elk over there. Look down. There's a shed right there. I went to walking and kicked something. Check that guy out. That's cool. That's cool, guys. Found the set. Heck yeah.
Shed. I finally found a shed. Today. Look at that. Isn't that cool? Little spike buck. Cowhorn spikes, what we call them. The other one might be right here somewhere. That's kind of neat. Right here on the edge of the field, just like I thought they would be. We might have another one laying here somewhere. Isaac found a matching set just a while ago on the edge of the field. So, I seen this one from quite a ways away. So, let's just keep walking. Maybe we'll find another one. Put that in your pocket. How fresh is that? It's pretty fresh. It's still got the skin.
Alright, guys, I'm going to stop the video for a minute. If I find another one, I'm going to follow this trail up this hill real quick, a little ways, because that's pretty steep and I can see where they're using that. And bigger deer might knock their antlers off coming down that, so let's try that. Alright, guys, we've decided to call it a day. We're driving back to town, and Isaac, he wins today. He found 3 sheds. We'll start with my little dinky one. I found this one, which you guys seen on the video, me finding it, and you guys will see where Isaac found his on the video, too. And then Isaac found this one first. This is the first shed of the day. And then Isaac gets luckier than anyone and finds a matching set. Not a monster buck, not a real big buck, but, hey, it'll work. I can't believe he found a matching set. That's awesome. That's rare, especially around here. That's really cool, though. Congratulations, Isaac.
It's just because I'm lucky.
He stole my luck. Usually I'm the one finding them. But anyway. I found one big one. Two big ones.
Still didn't add up to what mine was.
Yeah. There goes that fun time attitude. But anyway, be sure you guys like, subscribe, comment down below what you guys want to see us do next. God bless you all. Have a great day. Just gotta get that senior peace sign out. Later, guys. We're not being quiet by no means. Let me get a little bit closer. He's probably a good 10 foot away. We'll go right out. He's got his head covered. What's up, little fella? He's attacking me. He wasn't running away. I thought he'd run away, but no, he's coming after me. Look at him. Now he's going to run away. There's some quick little dudes, too. They're almost like a mixture of a rat and a kangaroo. They're so cool, though. Those are some cool animals. You see the claws on that thing? All right, well, guys, I'm going to start heading back up this hill. I don't want to get too far off down in here because I don't know. I don't want to be too far away from everyone else. So we're going to head back up this hill. I think it'll lead me back to the field. If it don't, I know how to get back there from up here at least. There's a bunch of deer poop right here. All right, well, I'm going to stop this for now. And